camera action. I love the fashion. See me on TV, laid back, relaxing. Camera in my face, I am the talent. Bring it on, bring it on. I love a challenge. Before the Hype is brought to you by Ultra Lounge, Color Star Media.
I'd like to hear gibberish.
This is Gibberish by Malika Janelle, going out to caller number 6.
My name is Miss Kristen Dion with Before the Hype TV, and today we have the pleasure of speaking with songbird Malika Janelle.
How are you doing?
Great, thank you so much for being here.
Thank you for having me.
Yeah, so tell us what got you started with singing.
Well, I come from a large family of singers and songwriters and pretty much just all the arts. And my sister and my brother and I, we all started a music group, and we started our first little single, Woman You Need. We took our money together, went to the studio, recorded that, and, you know, tried to push that for a while. So, just doing it because it's in the family.
Wow. So how long have you been singing?
Since I was about 14.
14.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. That's when everybody knew I could sing.
Okay. It definitely came out like, okay, yes. I am a singer. Okay. And tell us, what is the name of your current single?
Gibberish with a J.
Gibberish, okay.
Yes.
So tell us, what is Gibberish about?
Gibberish is for the adult-minded.
You got me fantasizing about it, and I can't stop it. Ooh-wee, you're keeping me on your mind. You got me speaking gibberish. Gibberish, and I'm about to lose.
It's about just experiences that you have in relationships, more so on the intimate level.
Okay.
You know, so I can't go too much into that. I have to let people just interpret that themselves.
Okay, okay. Well, we definitely have to hear Gibberish.
Okay.
So we can see what that's all about. And tell us, what has inspired your music?
I guess music is just a big part of me.
Mm-hmm.
And when I listen to music, I've feel something. So when I create, I want people to feel my experiences, because that's mostly what I write about.
Okay.
Experiences for myself and other people that I've observed. So I might see somebody that's in a bad relationship and I might write about it.
Okay.
I might not speak exactly into terms, but
right, right.
You know, my opinion of how it comes off to me, I want people to see the same thing.
Okay, so you're also a songwriter.
Yes.
How long have you been writing?
Pretty much since I was about 14.
Oh,
yeah.
Okay.
Been doing it for a long time.
What type of genres do you like to write?
Neo-soul, jazz. I do a little country. I'm working on a little rock. And I do, of course, do gospel.
Oh, okay. Okay. And do you also sing country, rock, gospel?
Yes, I do. I have a little dabble of everything.
Okay, that's pretty cool. That's pretty cool. And, of course, we're going to have to put you on the spot to ask
okay.
you to sing a snippet of one of your favorite songs.
Okay. Well, I'll sing my next single that I'm going to release is Break Up Makeup.
Okay.
Every time we can get you off my mind, you got me losing sleep at night. Every time we break up, make sweet love, can't get you off my mind. You got me losing sleep at night. Yeah.
Wow, that was beautiful. Malaika, where can we find your music?
You can find me on Reverb Nation under Malaika Janelle.
Okay.
SoundCloud under Malaika Janelle. Facebook under Malaika Janelle. You can also see some of my videos on YouTube.
Okay.
I do have a new video for Gibberish.
Okay.
And Mr. Preston Kelly did that for me.
Oh,
okay. So you guys got to check this out.
Okay.
And he's also does the production with me as well.
Okay.
So Reverb Nation, you can find me on Facebook, Instagram. But the music you can find on Reverb Nation, SoundCloud, and Facebook.
Okay, and what can we find in the future coming from Malaika Janelle?
Well, I don't know yet. I don't know what's in my bag yet.
Okay.
So I'm still working on that. I want to, you know, to surprise people.
Okay.
Because I have a lot in me, so I want to express everything.
I know you're going to continue with your beautiful voice, but do you plan on writing for people in the future?
Oh, yes, definitely, definitely. And that's what I've been actually doing, a little bit of that already.
Okay.
So I'll be doing some collaborations with other people,
okay,
as well as writing for them, too.
Okay, that's pretty cool.
So you
cool.
might see a video with me in it.
Oh, okay. All right. We'll be looking for it.
Yes.
All right. And tell us as well, tell us about your support system for your music.
Well, of course, my family is really supportive of my music. And of course, those fans that I do have out, those little bit of fans I do have out there on Facebook, they are very supportive. They're the friends, those people I don't even know. Of course, Mr. Kelly, fucking Kelly, he's a big support system when it comes to my music because we create together. He does a lot of my multimedia as well.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, just having us working together as a team, it seems like we're getting a lot more done. And, you know, sometimes when we expand out to other people,
that's,
you know,
it's
because we have a chemistry there as far as with our music and production. It just, he starts playing and I start writing.
Okay.
And that's just how it works.
Well, that sounds like you have a great support system at
yes.
home. And we can't wait to see more from Malaika Janelle.
Thank
song,
you.
Songbird writer. She does it all. Look out for her, y'all. Before the Hype TV, it's been real.
How you feeling? It's yours truly, Mel Renzo. I want to let you know, for all you IG followers out there, make sure you log on to IG. Make sure you type in at Before the Hype TV.
Could have figured that paint up the paw. Better tell her them rims up the paw. Better know that them subs up the paw. Make a bra fall in love with the car. Sunroof, get it closer to the stars. Bench seats, get it closer to the kid. Right on, show her how I keep the player. Left on, show her how I work the wheel. Baby girl, this ain't what you think it is. This is much more than just a car. This that Southern playalistic. Riding dirty space, pimping double cup. No prescription sounds up. Speakers hitting, movie playing. Screen flipping, switching lane. Still tipping in and make the inside look something like a time machine. Press a button, baby, take you where you wanna.
Shh, be very, very quiet. I'ma sneak up on him on this one. Yeah. Yeah, you know I'm cold and I'm cold in. Yeah, it's like money over here, and that'll make them stare like money over there. And they ain't even fair, they throw it in the air like they ain't even care, and they ain't even share like. Yeah, you know I'm cold and Coca-Cola. You know I'm cold and Coca-Cola.
My name is Ms. Kristen Dion with Before the Hype TV, and we have the pleasure of speaking with Big Greg, rapper. And he has his new album out, Last Chance Mixtape.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you so much for being here.
Thank you for having me. I appreciate it.
Yes, thank you. So what got you started with rapping?
Music-wise, mm-hmm. I started, parents started a church, and they kind of just put a drum set out there.
Okay.
And that's the, they had all the other instruments, but I picked the drum set to jump on to try to get the church going. And after a while playing drums for since I was a little kid, you know, that's what music built up inside of me. And then got to college and I started putting together some words and, okay. and people were feeling it. So that's where I started at.
So it's all started back in the church.
Yeah, okay. It started in the church.
Okay. All right. And tell us, what type of music do you actually produce?
I don't know if there's an actual type for me yet because it's kind of, it's real laid back music and but it's still rap, you know. Mm-hmm. The hooks are a little laid back, chill. Sometimes I try to sing a hook if I can get a note out, and then
okay.
And then the rap verses are pretty laid back.
They be like, "Hey, Big G, what it do? I ain't never seen nobody do it like you. Striking paper like you, boy, kicking like you. Nary married to the game, and I tell her I do. Ain't never seen nobody do what I do. Probably be rich if you knew what I knew. Probably fly, flew what I flew, and you probably duck down if you knew what I drew. Hate to say it, I hate to say it, but somebody gotta say it. They gotta say it. This song, they ain't gotta play it. Ain't gotta play it up to you, but you know how I do. I gotta speak the truth." And I'm like, "What's your number, girl? I'm coming over, and we just coolin', girl. I barely know ya. How you do that? How you do that?" They asking me like, "How you do that? How you do that?"
All right, so tell us about your mixtape.
Last Chance, aka kitchen album, because I did it all in my kitchen.
Oh, wow.
I did it on my. I just found some program and put it on the computer and just started recording.
Wow.
So you just gotta work. I mean, you can't wait for other people sometimes to go try to find a studio and pay all this money. If you can try to do it on your own,
okay.
That's what I did.
What's your favorite song on your mixtape?
My favorite song is "New Day." Okay. A lot of people, you know, it's a real slow. It's a slower song, but "New Day" that's my favorite one. I mean, I got a couple rap. Upbeat tempo songs in there, but.
And what's the background of "New Day"? Like, how did you come up with that?
"New Day," that is just saying, you know, I mean, everybody go through some type of struggle, some type of problems, but "New Day" is just saying, you know, once you wake up in the morning, mm-hmm. it's a new day. I mean, you're alive, you're here,
okay.
you're able to, you know, go through these problems at least. So,
right.
It's a brand new day. It's, that's all I'm saying.
Over.
Yeah, you can. You know, at least you're alive. You know.
Okay. So tell us, can you drop us the line here from "New Day"?
The hook is, "It's a brand new day and I ain't worried what the haters gotta say. You know you got it. And I don't care about the chains or the money, I just throw it all away. You know you got it. Said I'm just cooling on them, cooling on them. Said I just cooling on them, cooling on them. And I ain't worried what the haters gotta say. You know you got it.
I used to play on them handlebars, yeah. And now I'm spitting, you can't handle bars, yeah. They call me punchline killer, cause I kill them with my lines like a dealer, no filler, yeah. See, I can take you to another level, yeah. Ain't no ladder, no shovel. Your boy got drive, no gas, no pedal.
Okay.
See, it's like a, you
new
know,
day,
a little singing.
Day.
A little okay. singing in a hook, but the verses, you know, try to rap.
And where can we find your music? Where can we download the mixtape, get a copy?
Yeah, DatPiff or DatPiff. You can get it on, just type in Big Greg, A Last Chance. Or you can go to Reverb Nation. You can listen to a lot of other songs I've done on YouTube. You go to Big Greg, and that's the two G's, BIGGREG, 4459. That should load up all my videos.
Okay. And it's called The Last Chance mixtape. So
oh.
Why is it The Last Chance?
Last Chance, that's a good story behind that, actually. That was, you know, I had my son, my first son, around this. I actually dropped it when he was born.
Okay.
And I basically felt like I had to start my full-time job, had my son. I wasn't going to have time to do a lot of music. So this is my last chance to reach out to somebody to try to, you know, a manager, a record deal, some type of thing.
Gotcha.
And it was just a shot in the dark. And then I found my Manifest Music.
Okay.
And he listened to Last Chance even like while I was doing it. And he wanted to be a part of it. So that's Last Chance. And so now I'm doing another album, even though that was called Last Chance.
Okay, what's the new album?
The new album is called G4.
Okay.
My name's Greg. And it's going to be the fourth album I've ever done. So,
okay.
And this one will be, you know, this is a mixtape, but this one will be all original beats, and it's going to be all mine. So.
That's pretty cool. And any upcoming events?
Upcoming events. I know we're going to be out in Lewisburg College next year. I believe it's going to be around March. We're going to be at NC State in April. I just got to go to maybe my Facebook page, Big Greg, to see those exact dates and keep up with that.
Okay, and tell us also about your support system.
My support system, honestly, it's like, it's my family, I have to say. Family and friends, I mean, they always, I don't have any empty shows. My family shows up.
Wow.
Friends will show up from high school and college. And, you know, I mean, my sons, they give me a lot of drive. So, you know, you die for your kids. So
right.
I keep going, and hopefully, you know, this will pan out to be something successful and be
Absolutely.
Able to get them whatever they need.
Okay, and what school did you go to?
I went to Campbell University out in the middle of nowhere.
Okay, I've heard of Campbell, okay.
But it was a good experience. I mean, a lot of money. I ain't saying I'm broke, but it costs a lot of money.
I know that goes. What was your major?
The major is criminal justice. I like the law and just how that stuff works and how they like forensics and all that type of stuff.
Okay. Do you ever talk about that in your music?
A little bit, but no, I try to stay away from
like,
that.
No, I'm gonna switch it over to something different. Okay. And so also tell us any other places we can find you. Instagram.
Yeah, my Instagram is gonna be Big Greg, Big Greg PLK. PLK used to be my name back in college, Punchline Kid, because I used to. We used to have little punchline battles. So Big Greg okay. PLK, you can find me on Instagram. Big Greg Nice, you can find me on Twitter.
Okay, Twitter.
Mm-hmm.
What about in Facebook?
Facebook is just Big Greg.
Big Greg. Mm-hmm. All right. Any other like SoundCloud or anywhere else we can?
No, just DatPiff. I mean, that's the best Dat place Piff. To get the whole entire mixtape. So, and like I say, YouTube, Big Greg 4459. You can find all the videos because I got some videos that I kind of shot.
Okay.
They're good.
And tell us, last but not least, is there anyone in the industry you want to work with?
Honestly, I feel like me and Drake have a similar vibe going.
Okay.
That's the only reason I would work with him. I mean, him and the whole Young Money crew, I look up to them. I like their music a lot. I mean, it's like every song is like a hit. It's ridiculous. But,
very true. That's true.
But that's what I mean. I would pick a girl like Rihanna or something, but that's for other reasons.
Okay.
I don't even care about the music.
But. Okay. All right. Well, it's been real. Enjoyed the time here with
Big Greg.
It was
nice to meet you.
Yes, it was nice meeting you too. And thank you so much for watching Before the Hype TV. It's been real.
Thank you.
Well, how's it going? It's yours truly, Mel Renzo. All my Facebook users out there, make sure you check out our Facebook page and make sure you like the page. It's at the Before the Hype TV. Got a lot of videos, a lot of interesting photos and information about what we got coming up in the future. So again, I said, at the Before the Hype TV on Facebook and make sure you like our page.
My paper getting thick, so I'm acting brand new, yeah, brand
My name is Miss Kristen Dion with Before the Hype TV, and today we have the pleasure of speaking with singer-songbird Amanda Pollard. Thank you so much for being here.
Thank you guys for having me.
Yes, so tell us, what got you started with singing?
I think it's just something that's really natural to me. Mm-hmm. I can't remember ever not singing. Like, I've been raised an only child, so I kind of talk to myself all the time. I just kind of sing all the time. It's just kind of sort of what I do, so.
Okay, how long have you been singing?
Formally, I guess, since I was a child.
Okay.
And then I attended Northwest School of the Arts here in Charlotte. And I just fell in love with performing. I fell in love with the stage. I fell in love with just everything about putting together a show. Mm-hmm. So it's just something I have to do almost.
Okay, so what else do you do outside of singing?
I love to read. I'm really kind of nerdy, so I am rereading Game of Thrones.
Okay.
I love. But yeah, I'm a bookworm too, so.
Okay. And where can we find you performing locally live?
Yes, I am open to bookings any and everywhere. Going to be performing at the Queen City Awards shortly, so okay. I'm really excited about that.
That is exciting.
Got something really exciting planned, so I can't wait.
All right, and tell us about your latest single.
Yes, earlier this year, I released my very first music video. It's called Let It Go.
Okay, Let It
Go. And I am just really excited about it. It was a lot of hard work going into it. Kind of did it ourselves, just me and my mom and my dancers. We just kind of hustled it out and made it happen. So I'm really excited about it. And you guys can check it out, youtube.com/Amanda's Music Online. Let It Go, in parentheses.
Title.
Yeah, I mean, sometimes like you get really stressed out and you just need to like hear your favorite music.
Yeah.
You just need to like dance and have a good time and just relax. And so that's kind of what the song is about, and just hopefully something to give people like a good fun vibe. So
I can let go.
Yeah, just let it go. Have fun. Chill out.
Okay. And tell us about some of your recent events that you've attended. Tell us about that.
Yeah, earlier this year, I was extremely blessed, and I won the Southern Entertainment Award for Performance of the Year.
Wow.
So I was like freaking out, like a Grammy Award winning producer gave me my award, so I'm just like trying not to say anything silly when I accept it. I'm just trying to remember like everybody who helped me, so it was extremely exciting.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah, it was. It was super, super cool. So that was definitely like one of the highlights of this year for me.
Okay, tell us about some of your previous awards. I mean, I've heard you sing personally, so you're great. So tell us about it. I know you have plenty.
I also won this year the Underground Music Award for Best Female R&B Pop Artist. And that was at Times Square at the BB King's.
Wow.
So it was really, really, really awesome. I'm still kind of like, did that really happen or did I make that up? But
wow.
And 2 Carolina Music Awards for Best Female R&B, a Queen City Award for Best Female R&B. So I've been really blessed with support.
Oh yeah, definitely. So. And so what's a piece of advice that you would share with someone younger aspiring to be a singer as well? Yeah.
Don't wait for anybody to help you. I did that. I waited. I was like, I need a manager. I need somebody to help me. I don't know what to do. I don't know how to get started. Just go out there. Don't be afraid to accept a gig. Find gigs. Ask. Don't be too embarrassed to just ask. Say, hey, where do I, can I perform at this event? I mean, even if they didn't ask you, just ask.
Right.
I mean, I wish I would have done that sooner, but that would definitely be my number one piece of advice.
Amanda Pollard.
In the industry that you would like to work with in the future?
Oh gosh, there's so many people. I'm a huge Usher fan.
Okay.
I think he's so dope. Like, he's one of the few artists that like is really like singing and dancing. He's going in. Like, the man is pouring sweat every time he gets off the stage. I'm like, yes, that's how you know you're doing it. Like, if you're not breaking a sweat, then what are you doing?
Right, right.
So I would love to work with Usher.
Yeah. Okay. All right, and also tell us any future projects you wish to be a part of or put together yourself in the industry.
One day I really hope to put together an album. It's not something that I've done yet, so I'd love to like really dig and just see, you know, what my thoughts and my feelings are creatively and just let it out and share it with everybody. So
gotcha.
One day.
One day, and I'm sure that'll be in the near future. And you heard it here. Amanda Pollard, thank you so much for being here.
Thank
this
you.
This girl is so talented, I tell you. And thanks for watching, guys. Before the Hype TV is being real.
Show you how love. Baby, in the past, love hurt you bad. So bad that you don't ever, ever want to let it back into your presence. But now's the present, and now's the time for you to seize what's right in front of you.